How's it going, my good friends? So good friends of mine are getting married soon and I want to get them something nice and pretty, and I've decided I will get them some cutlery because that's what you give for weddings. Anyway, so what I really want to do is to make a fork and a knife, one for each, I suppose, and I want to make them nice and pretty and hand-engraved, that is. And yeah, I hope you enjoy this video and hope it will be fun. The first step in this project will be a little bit different than what I usually make. I usually make the parts themselves, then I do the engraving. But this time, because the pieces would be quite small and finicky maybe, or something like that, I will do the engraving first. And so what also I'm gonna do this time, I prepared a print that I've drawn in the designs I want on Illustrator, and I'm gonna transfer them, and hopefully this will bring me much more accurate result. Normally I don't like to use the computer for the illustrations, but for this time, yeah, I want to try it out, and it's definitely gonna be one of the finest work I will attempt. It's really small. So we'll see if it works out. Now this one here, the two spirals here that are completely smudged, they are intertwined with each other, meaning they go through, like hooked, and this whole, the most complicated part of this whole engraving is smudged, but I'm gonna try to figure out anyway what I need to do. Alright, so here we go. I've done shaping the overall shape. Alright, let's try this again. I've done shaping the whole fork head at least. And I think, this is the time I want to move on to try to bend it. And this is where it all can go horribly wrong, but I will do a very minor bending, and I think after annealing, it should be pretty easy, I hope. Famous last words, as you say. So let's do that. Okay, so I have no idea what I'm doing, but I think it looks awesome, but I think it's way too much. Let me look at the real folk. Okay, now I understand what I've done wrong, is that this part needs to be straight. I think it still looks, I don't know, should I straighten it off? Maybe. I think I'm gonna anneal it again though, before. So I broke it. I really tried to make sure that I don't kind of hammer hardening the brass. So let's cut them off and reshape. Okay, now we're gonna make the handle a piece, which will be from this lovely maple. And I'm gonna make a collar. Yeah, let's do the collar first. Alright, so we have roughly our two shapes for the handle scales, probably not scales, but pieces. And I want to have a slight taper or something. Well, I probably should do the hole first. So this is how the fork will look like roughly. There's still some engraving that I want to do for the initials, but I will move on to the knife at this point. Okay, so this knife needs to be it needs to be called a knife, so it has to have some sort of edge to it. So I'll put a very, very tiny edge, just for, like a fish knife.
Moving on to the final part of the fork and knife, I just want to put some initials for the bride and groom, and so I will make a place for a coin-looking piece of brass where I will engrave the initials.
So I'm just about almost done with the main pieces. There's a few more cleanups I need to do for the colors, and I didn't really drive it in just yet. But I want to go ahead and do the casing or the mounting of the piece, which I'm gonna use this MDF here, and I'm gonna do this kind of a French lining, I think it's called, so you're not gonna see the MDF or anything like that. So every tiny drop of glue on the felt itself really shows up, and unfortunately I'm really bad with keeping everything sterile and clean. So I had a few spots here and I've used some water. Hopefully it will get rid of most of it. We'll see after the water dries. If not, I might try a patch. If not that, I will just do everything again, but we'll see. For now it looks all right. Like so. Probably should have put the glue on the felt itself, and now I'm rubbing glue all over the velvet. But it's going to be all right, believe me. We are going to prevail and conquer our innermost leprechauns. Okay, now for obviously the edges don't look don't look very nice. They exposed in the ethanol. So what I wanted to do for a while, and I didn't get really the chance, is I want to do some gold leaf. Gilding, right? Even though this one is not gold leaf, in the package it says it's a tin and copper leaves, which is literally brass. All right, now we need to leave it for 15 minutes, I think. I have to check. I think 15 minutes, and then we can completely mess it up with the leaves because I don't got delicate hands, so we'll see. Does it stick?
So I've decided to make another attempt at the gilding, and I've noticed that the leaves really show every texture of the surface underneath. So I've tried to seal the surface a lot nicer and smoother, and it worked out better, but I feel I can do it a little bit better in the future. But this is only the covering box, so it's not the end of the world. So there you have it, my friends. This is the final result, and I'm quite pleased with how the fork and knife turned out. I think they look really nice, and I really hope that my friends will like it. I have to be honest, now that I see it on camera and close up, I see how much more finish work I can give to the brass and get rid of all the scratches and really buff it and polish it really nicely. The other thing is that every time I edit these videos, I notice all the places, all the inaccuracies with my engraving. And I don't know if you know this, but I don't use any magnification since I just don't like it. It's not comfortable for me, and it's not a good experience for me. So I decide to go without it and, you know, go a little bit low-tech, a little bit more like the old times where there were no magnifications. Or at least I think so. But it's really good that I see it, because now I can reflect on it and try to do better in the future. So, my friends, I hope you enjoyed this one, and I will see you in the next video.